voltage. The spectral response are shown for the different materials, silicon, germanium, and selenium are shown, which indicates that it's a frequency selective device. So this device will not work for all light wavelengths or all frequencies. So the spectral response will clearly say what wavelength of light, if I illuminate the PN junction diode, how much voltage I'm going to get. Or I can easily say find out the peak lambda at which the peak voltage can be obtained. So the spectral response extends well into infrared region. The efficiency is quite high. We are going to use silicon and germanium, but predominantly people are using selenium because spectral response is similar to human eye. So all the visible light can be used in a selenium cell because human eye, you know, it is sensitive to all the visible light. We cannot see infrared and UV because the wavelength is very much invisible to our human eyes. And the ability to withstand damaging radiation environment up to 1,000 times stronger than silicon. So if we are going to make the solar cell based on selenium, and if you are going to use the selenium cell inside a nuclear reactor, so it can withstand the radiation environments very much up to 10,000 times stronger than silicon. So the same silicon cell will not work well if you are going to use it inside a nuclear power plant, but the same cell which is made up of selenium can work inside a nuclear power plant 10,000 times longer than silicon. Okay, so that is going to be the advantage of why you are using selenium over silicon and germanium. So this is the spectral response you can see. So this is for the first curve. The first curve is for selenium, and the second curve, this one is for germanium, and this one is for silicon. So you can find the silicon and selenium graphs are very much similar, but selenium covers the human eye radiation. So selenium, see, it covers the visible band. 400 to 800 nanometers, the visible band, it covers the visible band. Whereas silicon and germanium, you see, they are extending further into the infrared band also. And the impedance, you see, it provides 100% impedance. So the peak value is going to be 100% impedance is provided at visible light frequency in selenium only. Whereas in silicon and germanium, the peak is occurring at infrared frequencies, which is not visible to our human eye. Okay, so the characteristic curves of a light output voltage versus light intensity and output current versus light intensity are shown. So photovoltaic cells are used in low power devices such as light meters. So you, in a cricket match, when a test match is going on, you have to end the play. So the umpires will have a black color device and they will focus towards the sun and see what is the amount of sunlight they get, right, to whether to continue or stop the play. So those things are going to be photovoltaic cell. So based on the, when light is going to fall on those devices, where depending on the intensity of light, they can say whether it is bright or dark. So it is a handheld device, so low power device such as light meters are mostly made up of photovoltaic cells. And you can see this is the graph, light intensity versus output voltage. So as the intensity of light is going to increase, the voltage is increasing, both the open circuit voltage is also increasing, the voltage with load is also increasing. It is obvious, right? So when the intensity of light is going to be more and more, the output voltage will also be more. And same way, if you see, when the intensity of light is going to be more, the current is also increasing. So naturally, when V is going to increase, I will also increase proportionately, because you know Ohm's law, V is proportional to I. Okay. With the improvement in efficiency in these days of these cells, more power is produced, as in solar cells, which are photovoltaic devices. So they have modified the structure of devices, they have changed the materials, and they have made some improvement to the techniques which are used to fabricate these solar cells. So nowadays, conventionally, you say only 0.5 volt, I can generate in for silicon, and 0.1 volt for germanium in one cell, right? But that can be said to significantly increase nowadays because the efficiency is very, very good nowadays. So when operated in short circuit mode, the current is proportional to the illumination. So when you are going to use in short circuit mode, you can see the current is proportional to the illumination. So it is directly proportional. You get a straight line. You get an almost straight line, which is saying that in short circuit mode, when I'm going to increase my illumination, the short circuit current is going to be more. And it is used to construct a direct reading foot candle meter. That's what I said. If you want to read the light intensity coming from a particular object, I can use this photovoltaic cell. So it will produce an equivalent voltage proportional to the amount of light incident. And from that voltage, you can make out what is the range of intensity of light which is going to come in from an external source. So this is going to be the operation of photovoltaic cell. So photovoltaic cell works on photovoltaic effect, where I'm going to have a PN junction diode, which is not going to have any connections, biasing connection, forward bias, reverse bias, no. So I'm going to focus light on the depletion region. And the photovoltaic effect says that by the property of the device, the incident light energy is converted into electrical energy in the form of voltage or current. So you are producing voltage, and if you directly take that voltage from the device, you call it as open circuit voltage. If you connect a resistor and from the resistor you take that particular voltage, you call it as short circuit voltage. So that's what we have seen the graphs here, open circuit voltage and voltage at load. When the load is connected, what is the voltage which is measured across the load? That will be less than the open circuit voltage because you will have some loss because of the current flow through the wires. Same way, short circuit current and current at optimum load. So these graphs are also always increasing with the increase in the amount of light falling on the photovoltaic cell.